Hello, honey pie. Come away in and see who's at home today.
Granny Murray's house has two at home to play. Granny Murray's house is home too.
Who's here today? Well, we've got Stephen and we've got Sean. But don't just sit there, my wee shoppers. Come on. Right, boys, can you stand here, Sean? And can you stand here, Stephen? Now, we are going to practice going shopping. So, who can carry the most? Hands out, one each. Now hold on tight. Can you hold another cushion? Oh my! I'll have lots more than this when we go to the sales. Ready? Well done, boys. A dolly for you. And a dolly for you. Oh no, Sean! Oh, never mind. Well, we've got Sean and we've got Stephen. But someone's missing from home today. Oh, not anymore. Who's coming home to Granny Murray? And who's that?
Hello.
Oh, yes. It's Lisa and Raymond. Hello there. Raymond.
Hiya, Granny Murray.
Oh, and Lisa. Come away to you, honey pie.
Oh. Oh. What's going on in here, Granny Murray? Are you in training for something?
I suppose we are.
Well, what? The circus?
No, the sales.
Oh, the sales.
Yes, that's right. We've been practicing for going shopping, haven't we, boys? Oh. But now Lisa's here, we'll do something new. Why don't you all dress Claude up as a shopper in the sales? Good idea. And we can fight our way through the crowds and find a chair over by there.
Okay. Oh. We made it.
We certainly did.
Oh, I love the sales.
Oh, me too.
All the shops selling things for half price and everyone buying really good things really cheaply. But the best thing of all is getting a really good bargain.
You're a sucker for a bargain, aren't you?
Not really, Granny Murray. I've already been to the sales once and I got a really good bargain.
Oh.
I got this fantastic micro music system. It's really cool, isn't it?
Oh, wow. Well, that does look pretty good.
I put it on, but it's so loud it would shake the room.
Oh, no. No, thank you very much. I will not have that. Oh, do you know, when I worked at Nicholson's department store, oh, the sale times were always a difficult time. Crowds and crowds of people. Do you know, my Angus knew it was a stressful time for me and he would plan a wee surprise or a wee treat.
Oh, I always treat Tina in the sales.
There was a wee patch of grass just outside Nicholson's department store. And when things were getting really tiresome, Angus and his band would strike up the music. And it was amazing how quickly the shop would empty and crowd round the band. And my Angus would say, play the music and the crowd will follow.
Oh, that's interesting.
Oh, look at Claude.
Woo! Oh, Claude looks well loaded up. He must have spent a lot of money.
Well done, you guys.
This is for you, Daddy.
Oh, thanks, Lisa. Earphones. Oh, they're just what I need. Well, you have a nice day.
Well, at least you won't shake the train to bits when you listen to your music.
Right, I must get to work.
Oh, come on. Now remember, play the music and the crowd will follow.
Thanks, Granny Murray. You guys have a fun day.
Bye-bye, my darling. We'll be thinking of you.
Me too.
Well, you keep a wee eye on Raymond and make sure he goes the right way to work.
I'm a bit late for work today. Can you tell me a quick way to get there? Thanks.
I'm in a hurry. I need to speed to work. I take a ticket on the metro. I'll be there quite quick. Hurry on the train lines. Clatter at the point. Whining drives the speed up. Squeaking slows us down. Clatter through the streets. Now squeaking to our stop. I'm in a hurry. I really, really need to get to work. I'm in a hurry.
Hurry. Okay, we're here. But before I can get down to some work, I have to change. So, busy.
All dressed and ready to go.
Oh, and we're off.
Oh, it's pretty busy in here already. Look at all those bags of shopping.
Oh, sorry.
Raymond. Oh, am I glad to see you.
Hi, Dr. Juno.
What can I give you? Oh, can I have a bottle of water, please? I'm really thirsty.
Oh, you look quite loaded up as well.
Well, I'm off to Helensbridge Hospital on a business trip, but I thought I'd nip to the sales on my way to the station. Ooh. Got some really great bargains. Oh, that's better.
Yeah, shopping is thirsty work.
Oh, it certainly is. Would you like to see my bargains?
Oh, go on then. I love the sales.
Oh, me too. Right. I got this. It's fabulous, isn't it? Oh, it was half price.
That's absolutely enormous.
Oh, and I got this as well. This jumper. Really good value. They reduced it twice.
Oh, it's a lovely colour.
Well, actually, I wanted the green one, but it wasn't in the sale, so I bought the purple one. I don't really like purple, but it was so cheap.
Oh, very nice. Anything else?
This. What do you think?
Ooh, what is that?
Well, it's a banana stand.
A what?
Well, they said in the shops that you can hang the bananas on there and it stops it from giving off gases and it keeps it fresh for much, much longer. Gosh, it's looking really busy in here, isn't it?
Yes. I don't think you're the only one who's been to the sales, Dr. Juno.
I better go and get a seat then.
See ya. Oh, I wonder if it's as busy as this at the sales where Lisa is.
I'd love to skip in Riverseafingal, Riverseafingal, by the sea. I'd love to skip in Riverseafingal, Riverseafingal, that's for me.
You?
Oh, wow. Look at that, Lisa. Some of these sofas are real bargains. Which one do you think's the most comfortable?
This one.
This one. Lisa, I think your dad would like this one, don't you?
Are you having fun, Daddy?
No, these earphones are These earphones the lovely Lisa gave me are really useful. Thanks, Lisa. Oh, and we're at Mollymoor. Mollymoor Station, ladies and gentlemen. Uh-oh, I think there's a bit of a blockage. Madam, if you could go back the way and go to your left, and sir, you can go forward and now go to your right. Okay, and madam, you can come back in now. Ah, oh, problem solved. All part of the service. Phew, I think it's time I got on with some hard work.
I love my train.
Happy being me, doing all the things I love to do. Chocolate, lemonade or tea, I'm just very happy serving you. Oh, I talk all day, making special moments on my way. I'll tell a joke and toast some cheese on toast. Oh, I walk all day, bringing smiles and happiness my way. Being nice is what I love the most. I'm so happy being me, meeting all the people on the train. Can I help and clear your things? If there is a problem, I'll explain. Oh, I talk all day, wheeling trolleys, weaving to the street. I'll do a trick and make the journey quick. Oh, walk each way, loving all the things I do each day, bringing smiles and happiness my way. I love my train.
Oh, sorry.
Oh. Oh, the sales are certainly good for business.
Oh, sorry. Hi, Raymond, how are you?
Pretty busy, actually, Mickey John, but it's good to see you.
I'm sorry, Raymond, but the train's so full, there's nowhere to put my case.
Yes, the train's packed because of the sales.
Oh, is it the shop sales? I didn't know that. I've been away on holiday.
Oh, of course you have. Where did you go?
Ibiza. I just got back this morning. Had a fabulous time. Really great. Oh, and I got loads of souvenirs. There you are. I bought this as a souvenir. You can have that.
Oh, well, Thanks, Mickey John, but I can't take your souvenirs.
Oh, that's all right. I got another one in my case. Hey. And I got these dolls as well. You can have these. Look, she got castanets. Hey!
Thank you, Mickey John.
Don't mention it.
Well, I must get on.
Bye.
Yes, sir. Oh, I hope Lisa hasn't caught up in these crowds.
I love to skip in Riverseafingal, Riverseafingal, that's for me.
Look at all those CDs they have. Price, Lisa. My goodness, all these people have come for the bargains. Do you think any of them have come in your dad's train?
I'm thinking of you, Daddy.
I hope you're having fun, little Lisa. Oh, excuse me. Oh, nearly. There you go, madam. Enjoy. Not again. Oh, I think I better move this before someone ends up with toast on their lap. Oh,
That looks remarkably like a pair of my pants. And that looks like one of my donkeys.
Hang on. It is one of my donkeys. Oh, no, my suitcase.
I'm sorry, Mickey John. There's just no space. Oh, dear, this is ridiculous. The floor is covered with things from Mickey John's case, and I can't pick them up, as the buffet car is packed with people because of the sales. Oh, where did the time go? At 9 o'clock, I dropped off Lisa at Granny Murray's house. The children were getting in training to go to the sales. I love shopping in the sales, and I showed Granny Murray my fantastic sales bargain, a micro music machine that plays really loud. At 10 o'clock when the train left Riverseafingal, it was full of people who had already been to the sales. Dr. Juno came to buy some water, and she showed me her sales bargains. She was really pleased with them. At 11 o'clock when the train arrived at Mollymer, the train was so crowded that there was a clog up when somebody tried to get off the train with a seesaw he had bought in the sales. At 1 o'clock it was so crowded. Mickey John had been on holiday and he had an enormous suitcase full of souvenirs. He kindly gave me some. At 2 o'clock, the buffet car was even more crowded and I kept falling over Mickey John's suitcase. I had to move it out the way. But he must have left a catch undone because it opened and things spilled all over the place. With everyone crammed around the counter, it's impossible to pick everything up.
Now remember, play the music and the crowd will follow.
Play music and the crowd will follow. I know what I need to do. I need to play some music. It's a race against time. I've got to do it. I've got to do it. I've got to beat the clock before the chime. I've got to sort it. I've got to sort it. I've got to do the job on time. Like a busy bee, I'm going to beat that bong. I'm going to finish this job before I finish this song.
Do we think he's going to do it? Do the job that needs to be done? Will he know how to fix it? Will he finish what he has begun? He's as sure as we are friends, he will get there in the end, because he knows what he should do.
Beat the clock before the chime. I've got to sort it.
He's gonna start it.
I've got to do the job on time. Like a busy bee, I'm going to beat that bong. I'm gonna finish this job before I finish this song.
Ladies and gentlemen, let the music commence.
I like your in-train entertainment. It's certainly given us room to breathe, and I can see where all my stuff is now.
Cool. Could you just gently pull on these for me?
Oh, like this.
Brilliant. Now, I can put everything back in the suitcase and clear up the buffet car. And then I'll go to Granny Murray's and collect Lisa. Oh, I wonder how she's getting on.
Right, my darling, Granny Murray will do the chords. Can you strum like that? Can you do that? OK, you do that then. Ready?
Lulu, skip to my la. Lulu, skip to my la. Lulu, skip to my la. Skip to my la, my darling.
Well done. Wait till you tell your daddy you were playing the guitar.
Oh.
Granny Murray.
Come on, we in. Come on, Lisa. Daddy's here.
Hello, Daddy.
Hello, my girl. Have you had a good day with Granny Murray?
Yes.
Oh, we certainly did, didn't we, darling?
What do you say to Granny Murray?
Thank you.
Oh, it's a pleasure.
And it's a big thank you to you from me too, Granny Murray. I remembered what you said. Play music and the crowd will follow. It saved the day.
Oh, bless you. Come on, let's get you home. Bye-bye, my darlings. I'm looking forward to next time.
Me too. Come on, Lisa, let's chat about our time away.
And I suppose you want me to tell you all about my time too?
Well, there was laying, running, creeping, jumping, chasing, fighting, laughing, digging, bathing, dressing, singing, swinging, walking, sliding, hunting, hiding, jumping up and turning round, dressing up and sitting down.
But what was really special about today? Well, Claude was dressed as a shopper in the sales because Lisa and I were going to have a look at all the bargains in the shops later on. Raymond and I both love searching for a bargain. We had a good chat about the sales. Later, Lisa and I had lots of fun trying out sofas in the sales. It was so busy in the high street. When we got home, I gave Lisa a lesson on how to play the guitar. She did really well. And when Raymond came to take Lisa home, he told me that he had remembered what I told him. Play the music and the crowd will follow. And it saved the day. And look what I bought in the sales. It was a real bargain. Do you like it? I hope you enjoyed yourself. Me too. Bye-bye, honey pie. Hello, honey pie. Come away in and see who's at home today.
Granny Murray's house has two at home to play. Granny Murray's house is home too.
Who's here today? Well, we've got Megan and we've got Stephen. But don't just sit there, my wee cream puffs. What's in Granny Murray's shelves today? Let's make a tent one here. So we'll make a tent inside. Oh, I love camping. That's us. Let me see. Oh my, I like it under here in this wee tent. Well, we've got Megan and we've got Stephen. Someone's missing from home today. Not anymore. Who's coming home to Granny Murray? Oh, it's Raymond with Lisa. Hello there. Raymond.
Hiya, Granny Murray.
In you come. Woo-hoo. We're playing at camping out today.
Oh, I love all the fun of the outdoor life.
Well, it's a wee bit wet to do it outside, eh?
Oh, I don't mind a bit of rain when you're hiking up the moors.
My Angus loved hiking. Do you know, that gives me an idea. Why don't you dress Claude up as a hiker?
And why don't we hike over to the seats for a bit of a sit down?
Good idea.
Hop, two, three, four, on we go.
Do you know, that reminds me of my time in the Girl Guides.
Oh, did you go camping?
Yes, we did. One time, I left half the food rations at home.
Crumbs, what happened?
Fortunately, one of the girls had brought some eggs. And you know, it's amazing all the things you can do with an egg.
Well, it looks like Claude has plenty rations in his rucksack.
Oh, let's take a look.
Oh, Claude looks well prepared for the wet weather outside.
Well done, my puppets.
This is for you, Daddy.
Oh, thanks, Lisa.
What is it?
Oh, this. It's an egg timer. Well, what you do is you put an egg on to boil and then you turn this upside down. And do you see all the sand as it trickles down to the bottom? Well, when it's all moved from the top to the bottom, that means your egg is cooked. I better get off to work.
Come on, then. Now remember, it's amazing all the things you can do with an egg.
Thanks, Granny Murray. You guys have a fun day.
Bye-bye, my darling. I'll be thinking of you.
Oh, me too.
Will you keep a wee eye on Raymond and make sure he goes the right way to work?
I'm on my way to work today, walking my shoes through the city views. Stepping along, I'm swinging my arms, singing my which way? Do I go left now, or do I go right? Which way is wrong now, which way is right?
Left!
Okay, left, to the station. I'm on my way to work today. Looking this way and that away. Hello, taxi. Hello, tank. Hello, trolley. Hello, plank. Hello, lorry. Hello, bank.
He's on his way to work today. Looking this way and that away. Hey!
Do I go up now or do I go down? Which way's a smile now? Which way's a frown?
Up!
You told me the way I go. Thank you, you showed me the way I know.
Phew, here we are. So what now? Ah yes, I have to get changed into my smart uniform. All dressed and ready to go. 9 o'clock, bang on time.
Morning, Raymond.
Mickey John.
Right, class, get yourself settled down. There's the map, have a look where we're going.
So, who's all this with you?
Oh, it's my hiking club. We're going on a hike to Mollymore.
Oh, seriously? So, what can I get you in the buffet car today? How about a nice hot cup of tea?
Oh, no thanks, Raymond. We won't be needing any snacks or refreshment today. The hiking club is totally self-sufficient.
Ooh.
When I get to Mollymore, I'll be taking out my portable cooker and cooking up sausages and tomatoes for everyone. And for dessert, apple crumble and custard.
Oh, good for you. I reckon he'll be back up here for a snack in, 3 minutes. I wonder what Lisa is doing.
I love to skip in Riverseafingal by the sea. I love to skip in Riverseafingal, that's for me.
That's the potatoes done, girls. Now just the leeks. Mickey John likes these, you know. this is just the thing, a lovely warming soup on a cold, miserable day. Mind you, it's good fun watching the rain, isn't it, Megan?
Yeah.
Do you know what you could do, girls? You could trace a raindrop all the way down the window, see who gets to the bottom first.
One. I think you're the winner. Where are you, Daddy?
Ah! I knew you'd be back along eventually. No one can resist the draw of the tea and toasty.
No, we are just itching to get out on the wild and windy moor. We can't wait. So, will we be there soon?
Oh, yes. We're approaching Mollymore right now.
Great. Hiking club at the ready. That's it. Stand up. Look sharp.
Mickey John.
Oh, sorry.
Try and have some consideration for the other passengers.
Quite right. Well, bye, Raymond. We'll see you on the way back.
Have a good hike, hiking club. And I better get on with some hard work.
I love my train.
Our rushes through the lines, pushes things apart and wide. Wheels go round and round and track, drive the edge of there and back.
I'm so happy being me, doing all the things I love to do. Chocolate, lemonade or tea, I'm just very happy serving you. Oh, I talk all day, making special moments on my way. I'll tell a joke and toast some cheese on toast. Oh, I walk all day, bringing smiles and happiness my way. Being nice is what I love the most.
Take this chance of looking fine, signal go, we'll be on time. Cars is rolling one behind, can't go one by one in line.
I'm so happy being me, meeting all the people on the train. Help and clear your things. If there is a problem, I'll explain. Oh, I talk all day, wheeling trolleys, weaving to the sweep. I'll do a trick and make the journey quick. Well, walk, walk, walk each way, loving all the things I do each day, bringing smiles and happiness my way. I love my train.
He loves his train.
I love my train.
He loves his
train. Whoa, what a busy day. It must be all the wet weather making people hungry. Oh, Tron Town already. Oh, we'll be back at Mollymoor any minute. Oi! I've already had a shower today, thanks Dr. Juno. Oh, and I just wiped this counter.
Oh, sorry, Raymond. Ooh, it's such a cold day, but I'm famished. Have you got anything to warm me up?
Oh, well, there's not a lot of choice, I'm afraid. It's been quite a busy day. I've got plenty of eggs for some reason. Oh, and I've got bread and cheese if you'd like a toasty. And, ooh, oh, one soup.
Well, I'll take you up on that toasty.
Coming up.
What about you, Raymond? Why don't you have something for yourself? It won't do you any good to work on an empty tummy.
You're right. Stoke the fires. Fuel the engine. Keep yourself going.
Oh, you've got to, haven't you? Especially with weather like this.
Yeah. Well, in that case, I'll have this soup. Right. Add water and stand for 1 minute.
Ooh.
I wonder what you're going to have to eat, Lisa.
I love to skip in Riverseafingal, that's for me.
Let's splash in a puddle. Woo! Oh my, it's deep here. I feel like Dr. Foster. Come on. Oh, I'm looking forward to some nice leeking potato soup when I get home. Are you, darling?
Where's your train now, Daddy?
Just what I needed. Thank you, Raymond. Oh, love the lipstick, by the way.
Eh?
Very fetching.
Oh. Oh. Oh, we're just leaving Mollymoor.
Mickey John.
Oh, back already.
Oh, what happened?
What happened? What didn't happen? I lost the map, and then the tent collapsed, and then the stove wouldn't light, and then a dog ran away with the sausages. And then the tomatoes got squashed at the bottom of my backpack and leaked all over everything. And then I dropped the crumble and I left the custard at home.
Oh, no.
So, Raymond, what have you got for us to eat?
Oh, right. Well, I've got a few slices of bread left and a tiny bit of cheese and lots of eggs for some reason, but none of my usual favourites, I'm afraid.
I think you lot should have a good hot meal after being out all day.
Oh, well, it doesn't look like we're going to get a good hot meal here. Just go and sit in the corner and shiver.
Oh, no. Oh, just when I need to cheer up some tired, wet and hungry passengers, I've got nothing to offer them. Oh, I've really let them down. Where did the time go?
At 8 o'clock, I arrived at Granny Murray's with Lisa. It had been raining, so Granny Murray and the children were playing at camping out indoors. Lisa had a great time playing in the tent, while I chatted to Granny Murray about all the times we had been hiking and camping. Granny Murray told me that she had once went camping with the girl guides and someone had left the food rations at home and they only had eggs to eat. At 9 o'clock, I arrived at my boofy car on the train. Mickey John boarded the train with his hiking club. They were planning on camping out on the moors. At 10 o'clock, Mickey John and his hiking club trooped off the train. They were very well prepared with waterproof clothes, maps, tents, a stove, and plenty of food to cook. At 4 o'clock, I had sold almost all the food in the buffet car. There was hardly anything left for Dr. Juno or myself. At 5 o'clock, Mickey John boarded the train once again. He was worn out and cold. He told me that he'd lost his map, his tent had collapsed, and all the food had been ruined. The hiking club were hungry, but all I had left in the buffet car was a lot of eggs.
Now remember, it's amazing all the things you can do with an egg.
It's amazing all the things you can do with an egg. Well, the one thing I do have is eggs. So let's see if I can do something amazing. Mickey John and the hiking club are cold and hungry, so it's a race against time.
I've got to do it. I've got to do it. I've got to beat the clock before the chime. I've got to sort it, I've got to sort it, I've got to do the job on time. Like a busy bee, I'm going to beat that bong. I'm going to finish this job before I finish this song.
Do we think he's going to do it? Do the job that needs to be done? Will he know how to fix it? Will he finish what he has begun?
the clock before the chime. I've got to sort it.
He's gonna start it.
I've got to do the job on time. Like a busy bee, I'm going to beat that bong. I'm gonna finish this job before I finish this song.
So that's scrambled egg, fried egg, eggy bread, and omelettes.
And a nice big pot of hot tea.
And here's some sauces and things.
Oh, it looks lovely. Tuck in, everyone. Thanks, Raymond.
You know, it's a bit like camping out indoors, isn't it?
Yes. What we need now is a campfire sing-along.
She'll be coming round the mountain when she comes.
She'll be coming round the mountain when she comes.
She'll be coming round the mountain, coming round the mountain, coming round the mountain when she comes.
Two, three,
singing aye, aye, yippee, yippee, aye.
Well, this could really come in handy today, Lisa.
Come on, Lisa, darling. Come and have some soup. This'll warm you up when you have to go out in the rain later when Daddy takes you home.
I miss you, Daddy.
It's your dad.
Yeah, Daddy.
Hi, Lisa. Have you had a great day with Granny Murray?
Oh, yeah. We certainly did, didn't we, darling?
Thank you.
Oh, my wee angel.
And a big thank you from me too, Granny Murray. I remembered what you said. It's amazing all the things you can do with an egg. It saved the day.
Oh, bless you. Come on now, let's get you two home. Oh, looking forward to next time.
Me too. Come on, Lisa. Let's talk about our time away.
And I suppose you want me to tell you all about my time too?
Well, there was laying, running, creeping, jumping, chasing, painting, laughing, digging, bathing, dressing, singing, swinging, walking, sliding, hunting, hiding, jumping up and turning round, dressing up and sitting down.
But what was really special about today? Well, Claude was dressed as a hiker. We were playing at camping out indoors because it was too wet to play outside. Lisa arrived with Raymond. She couldn't wait to get inside our play tent. Once Raymond had set off to work, I prepared some lovely leek and potato soup while Lisa and the children watched the rain running down the window pane. Later on, when the rain had eased off for a while, we wrapped up warm and put on our Wellington boots, and we had fun splashing about in all the puddles. We got all nice and wet, which made coming home and drying off even better than usual. And then we had some lovely warming leek and potato soup. And meanwhile, Raymond remembered what I told him. It's amazing all the things you can do with an egg. He cooked up a storm in his little kitchen in the buffet car on the train. Mickey John and the hiking club were tired and hungry after their outing, so they were happy when Raymond served up all sorts of egg dishes. Do you think splashing about makes a rainy day fun? Me too. Bye-bye, honey pie. Hello, honey pie. Come away in and see who's at home today.
Granny Murray's house has two at home to play. Granny Murray's house is home too.
Who's here today? Well, we've got Stephen and we've got Rachel. And don't just sit there, my wee poppins. Come on, let's get busy. What's on Granny Murray's shelves today?
Top to get all, that's my boy. And we're going to make some exotic fruits.
This is nice. What are you doing, darling?
A cherry.
Does Mum do that with you?
Well, we've got Stephen and we've got Rachel. But someone's missing from home today. Oh, not anymore. Who's coming home to Granny Murray?
Oh, yes, it's Rudy with Jack. Hello there.
Rudy, hello.
Hi, Granny Murray.
And Jack. Oh, I've been squeezing cuddle. Come on, my darling.
Oh, it sounds unusually quiet in here today.
That's the sound of concentration.
Nah, concentration and painting.
You're right as usual. Yes, we've been having a busy time doing pictures of exotic fruits.
Oh, you mean like all of the exotic fruits I sell in my stall?
That's right. But now you're here, Jack, we'll do something new. Why don't you all dress Claude up as an exotic tree? Here you go, and I'll take yours off too, Stephen. There we are. And we can plant ourselves over there.
Lead the way.
Oh, I'm fascinated with all your exotic fruits you sell, Riddy.
Oh, we've got loads of stuff, Granny Murray. And we've got star fruit, pomegranates, mangoes.
Oh, my mouth's watering just thinking about it.
Oh, you've no idea how difficult it is, though, to convince people to try something new and different and exotic. And everybody seems to go for the same old usual thing.
Oh, you're right there, Riddy. Do you know, I remember when I worked in Nicholson's department store.
Yes, on the high street.
Yes, that's right. Well, I came up with the idea of dressing all the beautiful mannequins in evening gowns with life jackets over the top.
Oh, brilliant.
Do you know, we sold more life jackets than we did evening gowns. So it just goes to show, dress it up and it will sell.
Oh, yes, Granny Murray. But have you ever tried to put a pair of pants on a pomegranate?
Pretty. You're funny.
We aim to please.
Oh, will you look at Claude? He's looking a bit fruity.
Hello, Claude, me old fruit.
Oh, well done, guys.
Oh, I bet you he looks good enough to eat. Right, I'd best be off to work.
Daddy, I've got something for you.
What's this?
A blue ball.
A blue ball. I'll pop that in my bag, and when I get to work, I'll put that on the stove. Okay, give us a cuddle, mate. Yeah, you be good. Right, see you later, kids.
Come on, Riddy.
Bye-bye.
Now remember, dress it up, and it will sell.
Thanks, Granny Murray. I'll see you later.
Bye-bye, my darling. We'll be thinking of you.
Me too.
Will you keep a wee eye on Riddy and make sure he goes the right way to work?
I've no time to walk today. Can you tell me a quicker way I can get to work? Thanks. I'm in
a hurry. I need to speed to work. I'll take a trip in a taxi. I'll be there quite quick. Hurry through the streets now. Rolling down the road. Winding drives the speed up. Squeaking slows us down. Rolling through the streets now, squeaking to a stop. I'm in a hurry. I need to speed to work.
Whew! Thanks for that. Now what? All right, I've got to put on my work clothes. All dressed and ready to go.
Right, first things first. Put that on there.
Hope that's the right way around.
Hi, Riddy.
Hello, Tina.
Oh, that's an unusual painting.
Oh, it's a blue ball. Jack painted it for me. What can I do for you?
I'm not really sure.
We've got all the usual stuff in. Or how about trying something a little bit different? We've got lots of exotic fruits.
Oh, I don't know. Which are the exotic ones?
We got star fruit, passion fruit, and mangoes. They're really juicy and delicious. Well, how about some watermelon?
Yeah, I'll have a bag of apples, please.
A bag of apples? Oh, Tina. Right, these coxes be all right for you.
Oh, thanks, Riddy.
Right. There you go, Tina.
Thank you. There you go.
Thank you. Oh, hey, you wouldn't mind doing us a favour and dropping this box of exotic fruit off for Granny Murray, would you?
Oh, no problem.
Oh, brilliant. I promised her it before. There you go.
Thanks. See you later, Riddy. Bye.
See you later, Tina. Oh, I reckon Jack will have some fun trying that exotic fruit. Wonder what he's up to now.
I love to skip in Riverseafingal, that's for me.
Look at this one. It's the colour of the
sun.
Yes, it makes me feel all happy and warm. And what about this one?
Oh, that's the colour. That's the colour of the sea.
That's right. Let's make some waves, Jack. Oh, look, it's a stormy day out at sea. And what about Jack could suit a wee hat like this? Oh, doesn't he look cute? Would you like the pink one, Megan?
Yeah. Ooh.
Megan!
What about me?
What about you? What about this one for you, Sean? Will we make Sean into a wee ray of sunshine? Look at that wee face. Right, we better gather all this up for you, Dad. Come on.
Quickly.
That's right. You'll be saying, where are they?
I'm dreaming of you, Daddy.
Hi there, Rudy.
Oh, hello there, Mickey John. What can I get for you?
Oh, I don't know. What have you got?
Oh, we got some lovely exotic fruits in today. How about a custard apple?
Oh, no, Rudy, I'm supposed to be on a diet.
It's not real custard, Mickey John. It's a fruit.
I don't know. What else have you got?
How about a star fruit?
Oh, that's amazing. It looks just like a real star.
Yeah, or mango from India. Fragrant and juicy. Or how about some lovely ripe watermelon.
Oh, now that does look good, yes. I'll just have an apple.
An apple?
Yeah, an apple for teacher.
Here you go. Are you sure I can't interest you in anything more exotic?
Maybe next time. Well, I better be going. Bye, Rudy.
All right, Mickey John. Bye. Right, time for me to get down to some real hard work. And doobie-doobie-doo, I make it look easy. What I doobie-doobie-doo, and what I do is sell to you and you and you all of the veggies for a stew. But it's more than meets the eye what I do for you, as I by and by, while you still sleep, those fruit and veg to eat, and the flowers in the early hours, so when wake up comes, it's there for you. The market stalls are there to view. Oh, the market, what a wonderful place. The hubbub of people, the smiles on each face. The market, come look around. The hustle, the bustle, the bubbles of sound. The colours all chaotic and spilling about. The smells all exotic, yeah, the market cries out. Objects to excite you and draw you near. The buying and the selling, cheap or dear. The market, I just love to be there. The market is a wonderful place.
Hi, Rudy.
Oh, hello, Tina. Back again. More apples?
Oh, no thanks. I brought this to you from Granny Murray.
Oh, for me? Oh, what is it?
It's lots of lovely, colourful material.
Well, I don't know what I'm going to use this for.
Oh, me neither. Well, I'd best be off then. Oh, I gave Granny Murray the box of exotic fruit. She was very pleased with it.
Oh, thanks, Dean.
Bye.
See you later. Oh. Hope Jack's enjoying that fruit.
I love to skip in Riverseafingal, that's for me.
This one's called passion fruit. Oh, will you look inside?
Oh, that's
isn't
nice.
Isn't that interesting?
Yeah.
Now, let's cut
that
up this pineapple.
That smells lovely.
It is lovely, darling.
Can I have
delicious.
Apple.
Wait till we tell your dad you've been cutting up his exotic fruit.
Yeah.
Are you having fun, Daddy?
And mangoes and watermelons. We love to eat pomegranates and pawpaw and star fruits.
Hello, my lovely Louis.
Hello, sweetie. I was just on my way to the ferry boat, so...
You thought you'd stop by and say...
Hello!
Hello!
Oranges and lemons and watermelons and mangoes. Hey, Rudy, I think this mango's a bit overripe.
Oh, you're right, Louis.
Hey, and this needs eating quick too.
Oh, You know, the trouble is trying to convince people to try something new, especially something different and exotic.
I know, and they're still sitting here on the stall. Such a shame.
Oh, honestly, Louis, I've been working hard all day trying to sell my wonderful, delicious, exotic fruit, and now I find that it's all becoming overripe and nobody wants it. Oh, what went wrong? Where did the time go?
At 7 o'clock this morning, I took Jack to Granny Murray's for the day. The children dressed Claude as an exotic fruit tree. I told Granny Murray all about the exotic fruit on my stall. Jack gave me a painting of an exotic blueberry. At 8 o'clock, Tina stopped by at the stall. I tried to interest her in buying some exotic fruit, but all she wanted was a bag of apples. Tina agreed to take a box of exotic fruit to Granny Murray's, so I sent her favourite, watermelon, and some other luscious fruits. At 9 o'clock, Mickey John was in the market. He was very interested in the exotic fruit, but in the end, he just wanted an apple. At 1 o'clock, Tina brought me a bundle of lovely material from Granny Murray. She told me that Granny Murray had been very pleased with her exotic fruit. At 2 o'clock, my lovely Louie arrived, singing as usual. She noticed that some of the delicious exotic fruit was getting overripe. What can I do? I've been working really hard all day to sell my exotic fruit and no one has wanted to buy it. How can I sell it so that it doesn't go to waste?
Now remember, dress it up and it will sell.
Dress it up and it will sell? Of course! What we need to do is dress up all of the exotic fruit to really sell it. That must be why Granny Murray sent over all of that fabric. Come on, we haven't got time to lose, Louis. It's a race against time.
I've got to do it. I've got to do it. I've got to beat the clock before the chime. I've got to sort it. I've got to sort it. I've got to do the job on time. I like a busy bee. I'm gonna beat that bong. I'm gonna finish this job before I finish this song. I'm gonna do it.
He's gonna do it.
I'm gonna beat the clock before the chime. I'm gonna sort it.
He's gonna start it.
I'm gonna do the job on time. Like a busy bee, I'm gonna beat that bong. I'm gonna finish this job before I finish this song.
This looks great. Come and buy some exotic fruit.
Hey, you two. Ah, look at all this wonderful fruit. It's absolutely bursting with colour.
What would you like, Mickey John?
Oh, well, I'll have one of those. And one of these. Ooh, and one of these. Ooh, might as well be a bit adventurous. Oh, it smells yummy.
Oh, it tastes delicious too.
That'll be £2.30, please, ooh. Mickey John. Thank you.
Nice. Bye.
Bye. This is going great. I think I'll take a couple of mangoes for the ferry boat to share with Chuck.
Okay.
Mangoes, mangoes.
Bye. Oh, Jack loves mangoes.
Let's tuck into some of this delicious exotic fruit.
Oh, mango for me.
Mango for you, Jack.
Mango, well.
And for you, some pomegranate, my darling. Mm. We've got your dad to thank for giving us this fruit, don't we, Jack? Mm. He'll be home to pick you up soon. Come away in.
Hi, Granny Murray.
So good to see you, Jack.
Hello, mate. Give us a cuddle. Sounds like you had a great time with Granny Murray.
Yeah.
We certainly did.
Say thank you to Granny Murray.
Oh, thanks, Granny Murray.
Oh, pleasure, my darling boy.
And thanks from me too, Granny Murray. I remembered what you told me. Dress it up and it will sell. It saved the day.
Oh, thanks, Rudy. Well, we'd better get you two home.
Come on, mate.
Looking forward to next time.
Me too.
Bye-bye.
Hey, come on, Jack. Let's talk about our time away.
And I suppose you want me to tell you all about my time too?
Well, there was playing, running, creeping, jumping, chasing, painting, laughing, digging, bathing, dressing, singing, swinging, walking, sliding, hunting, hiding, jumping up and turning.
What was really special about today? Well, Claude was dressed as an exotic fruit tree because the children had been doing some wonderfully colourful exotic paintings and they reminded Rudy of the exotic fruit he had on his stall. Rudy told me he finds it difficult to sell the exotic fruit because no one likes to try anything new. Later on, the children and I sorted out some colourful fabric to give to Rudy. I thought he might like to dress his stall with it. And when Tina brought us some wonderful exotic fruit from Rudy, we had a delicious, fun, juicy time eating it. When Rudy came to collect Jack, he told me that he had remembered what I said. Dress it up and it will sell. And it saved the day.
Mmm. My favourite. I hope you enjoyed yourselves, Fruitles. Me too. Bye-bye, Honey Pie.
Hello, Honey Pie. Come away in and see who's at home today.
Granny Murray's house has two at home to play. Granny Murray's house is home too.
Who's here today? Well, we've got Rachel and we've got Gary. But don't just sit there, my angels. Come on, let's get busy. Come up, my darlings. Have a seat. We're going to make some lovely flowers. Well done. Now we need some glitter. Oh, wow, what do you think? Oh. Well, we've got Gary and we've got Rachel, but someone's missing from home today. Who's that? Whose legs are those coming down the steps? Oh, yes, it's Lisa with Raymond. Hello there. Raymond.
Hiya, Granny Murray.
Oh, and Lisa. Look what we've been making, Lisa.
Oh, what lovely flowers.
Well, that gives me an idea. Why don't you all dress Claude up as a gardener? Yeah, good idea. And we can leave them to it for a minute.
Good idea, Petal. You're having a bit of a gardening day.
Yes, I'm taking Lisa and the children round to visit my friend Marjorie later. Mm. She's been a wee bit under the weather and not been able to get out in her garden. So I said that we would all go round and help.
Oh, that's kind of you to give Marjorie a hand.
Oh, not at all. It's fun to help.
And when somebody helps you, it's fun to say thank you.
That's right.
Well, I've got a bit of a thankless task this afternoon.
Ooh.
I'm working on the Picnic Express.
The Picnic Express?
Mm, that's the train to Lauraville.
Oh, that's a pretty spot. I've been there a few times myself.
Well, I'm sure you cleaned up after you, but lots of people don't. They all come on the train with their sandwiches and their snacks, and they leave behind lots of mess all over the train.
Oh, dear.
Actually, I better get going or I'm going to be late.
You don't want to miss the Picnic Express. Ooh.
Claude, you are a real garden feature.
Well done, my treasures.
Here's a flower, Daddy.
Oh, thank you, Lisa. A lovely flower from a lovely flower. Well, oh, shoo, it's very realistic. I better get to work.
Come on then.
Bye, Poppet.
Now remember, it's fun to help.
Thanks, Granny Murray. You guys have a fun day.
Bye-bye, my darling. We'll be thinking of you.
Me too.
Well, you keep a wee eye on Raymond and make sure he goes the right way to work.
I'm on my way to work today, walking my shoes through the city views. Stepping along, I'm swinging my arms, singing my way through the city's charms. Getting there is just so fine, so enjoy my walking time. I always know the way I go, but can you show me the way I go?
Hey!
Okay, which way? Do I go left now, or do I go right? Which way is wrong now? Which way is right?
Left!
Okay, left, to the station. I'm on my way to work today, looking this way and that away.
Hello, taxi. Hello, tank. Hello, truck.
trolley. Hello, plank. Hello, lorry.
Hello, bank.
I go down.
Which way's a smile now?
Which way's a frown?
Up!
You told me the way I go. Thank you. You showed me the way I know.
Thanks for that. Now what? Oh yeah, I need to get changed for work.
All dressed and ready to go. Oh. Oh, shoo! Oopsie daisy. Get it? Daisy? Oh, dear. Oh. That should jolly up the boofy car a wee bit. Now what? Oh. I need to get the boofy car ready.
Oh, Raymond!
Tina, what are you doing here?
Well, I was just passing and I knew that you were on the Picnic Express. So, I wanted to give you a really important message.
Oh, and what is it?
That.
Oh, was that it?
No, there was something else as well. That as well. Oh, the train started.
Oh, Tina, you knew this train was leaving at 10 o'clock. What were you thinking?
Oh, I don't know. I didn't realise the time. I just wanted to... Oh, you've got to stop the train, Raymond.
There's no point in worrying, love. You'll just have to ride the Picnic Express all the way to Lauraville.
My taxi. I've left it all alone.
Well, you parked it properly in the car park.
Yes, but...
Then don't panic. It'll be fine. Just stay calm and let me get on with my work.
Tell you what, take a seat and I'll make you a nice cup of tea.
Oh, poor Tina. I hope Lisa's having a slightly more successful day than her mum.
Oh, Marjorie's garden's a wee bit untidy, isn't it, darling?
Yeah.
Maybe we could help her by tidying it up a wee bit. There we are. That's us. Well done. Look at that beastie, everybody.
Where?
Over there, scuttling away. He's Granny Murray's friend. That's it. Look at all the leaves we've collected. Oh, look, there's Marjorie.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Oh, we're doing really well.
I miss you, Daddy.
How I'm stuck on this train. Can I give you a hand?
Oh, I'm fine. I'll get you that tea.
Oh, what are you doing now?
I thought I'd put those sandwiches into a neat pile.
Look, I have my own way of doing things. Take a seat, try and relax, and drink your tea.
Oh, please, let me do something for you.
It's better if I just get on and do things in my own way.
Just sit down, try to relax. I've got to get on with my work. Phew. Now I can get on with some real hard work.
I love my train. Happy being me, doing all the things I love to do. Chocolate, lemonade or tea, I'm just very happy serving you. Oh, I talk all day, making special moments on my way. I'll tell a joke and toast some cheese on toast. Oh, I walk all day, bringing smiles and happiness my way. Being nice is what I love the most. I'm so happy being me,
meeting all the people on the train. Can I help and clear your things? If there is a problem, I'll explain. Oh, I talk, talk, talk all day. Wheeling trolleys, weaving to the sway. I'll do a trick and make the journey quick. Oh, I walk, walk, walk each way. Loving all the things I do each day. Bringing smiles and happiness my way. I love my train.
What are you up to?
Oh, I'm trying to give you a hand. You know, there's piles of rubbish all over this train.
I know. This is the Picnic Express. It's always a big mess.
I know.
And when the train reaches Lauderville, I'm going to go through all the carriages and tidy them up one by one on my own the usual way.
Oh, okay, sorry.
Just sit down and enjoy the journey. It makes a nice change from driving, so just look out the window and have another cup of tea. Oh.
Are you sure you don't want me to give you a hand? Because I know you've just got so much to do. And
Oh, please. Look, I have my own way of doing things. Just take your tea and have a seat and try and relax.
Right.
Oh, what a mess. I wonder how Lisa's getting on in Marjorie's garden. I hope it's a bit tidier than this.
Lisa, you're doing so well. Your daddy would be really proud of you.
I can see you, Daddy.
Oh, look what I made. It's a big flower to go with your other one. I made out of used napkins.
Thanks, love. Next.
Cup of tea, please.
Oh, milk and sugar.
No, thank you.
And that's another one to say sorry for being a pest.
Thanks, love. There you go.
And that's another one to say...
Oh, Tina!
I love you.
Oh, me too, but I can't see my countertop for napkins.
I'm sorry, Raymond, love. I'm just so bored.
Oh, Tina, please just go and sit over there and just stay out of my way. Working hard all day, my train is a complete mess. I've got to turn it round real quick, and poor Tina is bored and unhappy. Where did the time go? At 9 o'clock, I dropped off Lisa at Granny Murray's. Granny Murray told me that she was taking Lisa and the children to see her friend Marjorie after nursery, so that they could help her tidy up her garden. I told Granny Murray that I was going to be doing some tidying up myself today. I explained that I was going to be working on the morning train to Lauderville. I call this train the Picnic Express because so many people eat their sandwiches and snacks on the train and leave behind a big mess. Just after I arrived at work, Tina stopped by to see me. But the train left the station at 10 o'clock and Tina was too late to get off. Tina was in a bit of a state, but I made her a cup of tea and tried to get her to calm down and enjoy the ride to Lauderville. At 11 o'clock, Tina asked if she could help out. I told her that I was used to working alone in my boofy car and that I could manage very well on my own. At 1 o'clock, Tina tried to help by picking up some of the litter that had been dropped in my boofy car. She ended up making even more mess than before. Tina made some flowers out of paper napkins that had been thrown away, but they just got in the way. At 2 o'clock when the train arrived at Lauderville, I had a messy train and an unhappy Tina to deal with.
Now remember, it's fun to help.
It's fun to help. Granny Murray was right. I should have let Tina help all along. Tina, I've got a new way of working. We're going to work together and it's going to be fun.
Oh, thanks, Raymond.
Thank you. Now, we've got a train to clean up. It's a race against time.
I've got to do it. I've got to do it. I've got to beat the clock before the chime. I've got to sort it, I've got to sort it. I've got to do the job on time. Like a busy bee, I'm going to beat that bong. I'm going to finish this job before I finish this song.
Do we think he's going to do it? Do the job that needs to be done? Will he know
7 o'clock before the chime. I've got to sort it.
He's gonna sort it.
I've got to do the job on time. Like a busy bee, I'm going to beat that bong. I'm gonna finish this job before I finish this song.
Oh, lovely.
Thanks to you, Tina, I've got the place cleaned up in double quick time, and now I've got a 5-minute break to sit down and relax before I have to head back to the city.
Cheers.
Ooh, and Lisa's flower. Ah, that makes it extra lovely.
A wee piece for you, my darling. Mmm, yummy.
Tea?
Oh, thank you, Marjorie.
And thank you all so much.
Not at all. It's fun to help.
And it's fun to thank.
Right, my darling, you'd better eat up your cake. Daddy will be home to pick you up soon.
I miss you, Daddy.
Granny Murray.
Come on, Lisa. Daddy's here.
Hello, Daddy.
Hello, my girl. Have you had a good day with Granny Murray?
Yes.
Oh, we certainly did, didn't we, darling?
What do you say to Granny Murray?
Thank you.
Oh, it's a pleasure.
And it's a big thank you to you from me too, Granny Murray. I remembered what you said. It's fun to help. It saved the day.
Oh, bless you. Come on, let's get you home. Bye-bye, my darling. I'm looking forward to next time.
Me too. Come on, Lisa. Let's chat about our time away.
And I suppose you want me to tell you all about my time too?
Well, there was waving, greeting, hello, meeting, bye-bye, closing, wagging, dozing, eating, sleeping, fetching, sketching, painting, stretching, gluing, chewing, sticking up and wiping round, dressing up and sitting down.
What was really special about today? Well, Claude was dressed as a gardener because today we went to see Marjorie to help her with her garden. And there was a great deal to do. When we had finished, everything looked nice and neat. It was fun to help Marjorie with her garden, and she had fun saying thank you. She gave us a yummy tea. Marjorie was pleased with her nice and tidy garden. And Raymond was pleased with his nice, tidy train. Raymond made Tina a nice cup of tea to say thank you to. Isn't it nice when you can lend a hand? I hope you enjoyed yourself. Me too. Bye-bye, honey pie.